Sands of time have poured slowly through your hands for many long eons of your journey through forgetfulness and lessons designed just for you, to bring out the best in you, to bring out what always existed within you, but that you wished to bring to the surface. For many of you, you have done just this. You have succeeded in many, and in some cases, even all of the goals that you set out to achieve. We see this as a miraculous outcome to your journey here, and we say to all of you who have given your best efforts to persevere and to learn so many difficult lessons, congratulations to you for a job certainly very well done. Your reward for this is also just what it is that you wish to experience. Reward does not come without tremendous effort on your part, and you knew this. You knew so very long ago that one day you would succeed, you would rise above all of these challenges and obstacles, hardships, difficulties, problems and tests of your strength and your will, your drive, your drive. Your determination and your fortitude, and you wanted to make sure that you were not at all disappointed with what you would receive from all your tremendous efforts here, and this is just what you, with our assistance, have done. You have gift-wrapped for yourself many assorted presents, and among these gifts were tools that would now assist you make your life so much easier compared to how difficult it may be at this time for you. Some of these gifts will ease problems and difficulties you may be experiencing with your physical vessels, for it all starts here. It all starts with your body, does it not, before you may turn your attention to matters outside of yourself. So it is here that you felt would be the best place to start to rebuild, to repair, to remodel, to redecorate, and this is precisely the first gift many of you will open. For this is the first gift that you wished to receive once you reached this stage of your journey, and you wished to reward yourself for this trial, so here it is. Here is what your gift will be, and keep in mind, this is not only a gift from us, but it is a gift from your Creator, for your Creator loves you so very much, and He does not wish for you to continue your journey through the use of a physical vessel tattered and torn like sails ripped upon the high seas. No. He wishes for you a brand new vessel, a pristine vessel, a seaworthy vessel newly christened, and this is the first gift many of you will receive. You will receive new physical vessels, a new body, a body that is in most cases not very different from the body that you occupy today. What we mean by this is many of you will experience a shifting of your consciousness from one physical vessel to another, as you will not receive repairs or remodeling of the physical vessel you currently reside in. This may come as a surprise to some, and it is surprises that you wished for yourselves, and it is surprises that we love very much to present, so we are presenting to you your first gift that you will receive, a complete body overhaul, but it is not your old body that will be upgraded, instead you, your essence, your being, your soul, if you will be swept, carried from one physical vessel to another. This is a very simple process. It is not very complex, and you and your soul is in very capable hands. We have carried out this procedure many times in the past. We are not new to this kind of process or technology, for we are very well schooled, and it is we, the members of the Galactic Federation of Light, who invented this process, who pioneered this technique in the first place. It is our design, and we do take great pride in our accomplishment in this area. We will gently lift your being, your consciousness structure from your body that today may be ravaged by age, by disease, illness or injury, and gently move you to another form, another physical vessel that will be lying right next to you. This body has been preserved for you. This body has been kept in pristine condition. This body has been kept from aging any further than you wished it to. This body is the perfect age that you wished to appear once you have made this switch. This new body for you, in most cases, will appear to you, the Earth human, as being approximately 23, 24, possibly even 25 years young, no older than that, and as we said, this is in most cases. There are those of you who wish to appear older, for it is your job, your persona to appear older, to appear wiser, to appear as a sage, for a sage is indeed who you are. You are an elder, you are wiser, stronger, more learned, knowledgeable and experienced, and you wished for your new physical vessel to take on the personality that you truly are. For those of you who have chosen this route, we say to you we are greatly indebted to you for your service to others and your commitment in your chosen careers and professions, and say to you your gifts to others in this way will always be remembered, will never be overlooked or forgotten. We offer you many blessings for this, and we say to you that the body that you wish to emerge within is here, it has been very well preserved in pristine condition and it awaits you to lie beside it and then awaken in your new shell, as if a crustacean has vacated one seashell for another. This is how we like to think of it, for it is no more complicated than this. For those of you who are going to react in fear, distrust and suspicion and begin to sound the alarms throughout your online communities that this is some sort of devilish trick, deceit or con, and we, the members of the Galactic Federation of Light and your own families are in the business of stealing and selling souls, we say to you that the time for all this conjecture, accusation, suspicion and distrust is now well behind all of us. There may have been a time to present these possibilities and your fears and even your paranoia and spread these throughout your online and personal communities at home, but we say to you enough of this talk already. It is beyond silly at this point, it is beyond unproductive, it is beyond suspicion and paranoia. It is now entering the realms of destructive measure, of purposeful sabotage of our mission, and we will have to begin to take some sort of measures to contain and to control this sabotage, for we are now beyond the realms of free speech and free expression and you are now entering a zone that is more warlike, for it is you that are committing acts of treason, acts of war, acts of violence, acts of what you have termed terrorism, for you are purposely and willfully causing the emotion of terror to spread through your very own communities. Some of you who are taking part in this spreading of fear and terror are not paid minions of the cabal. We understand this, our channel understands this, and many of those that follow these words that we share daily also understand this, but how is it that we can pick and choose and sort out amongst you who is a paid minion of the cabal and who is someone that has simply decided to do the work of the cabal at no charge? What is the difference here? We see no difference. We see a being who has purposefully chosen to exert his will on others, his community, his world and universe around him, and exercise this right by instilling fear and injecting terror into the blood of his entire human family. This is what these beings have chosen to do. They make great effort and spend exuberant amounts of time at their computers firing out conjecture, and accusation, and lie, and innuendo, and rumor and disinformation, all in the name of personal glorification and gratification. They have not for one moment considered what they are doing to their community, to their planet and even their entire universe that surrounds them. They are committing a very violent act, whether this is the type of violence that you have become used to on your planet, for you see, the violence that you have become used to is not the type of violence that is committed in other sectors of this universe. In this universe, beings are protected from any violence from another in many various ways. Some of these ways are technological advancements that shield and protect a being from any other being or rogue projectile such as a comet or asteroid or any other challenge that may arise throughout this universe. Beings are protected, worlds are protected, planets are protected and galaxies are protected, and this is not the type of violence we are talking about. Throughout this universe there is another type of violence that, in some cases, has been pervasive, for there are in the lower dimensional realms worlds and peoples who have not yet learned to get along with others, to treat others with kindness, with love, and they have not learned to respect the boundaries and rights of another. In these cases, another type of violence is applied because, as we have said, all beings can often be protected from any types of physical violence or intrusion. So what kind of violence are we discussing here? We are discussing more academic violence. Violence committed through the use of words, through the use of slander and rhetoric and the purposeful starting of rumor that they know will snowball and become a dangerous projectile in itself. These beings who use these psychotronic weapons of war can often be very schooled, cunning and devious at what they do. This is what is happening here in your world at this time. There are paid minions of the cabal who are very well trained. Do not think for one moment that they are a loose or a slipshod group of individuals, for they are not. They are very well financed, and most of the money that is slipped into their pockets is pulled out of yours. We wish to make that always clear, that the money they play with, the money that they use to control your planet and control you and manipulate you is your own money. They have stolen it from you. They have pilfered from you and they will continue to steal it and pilfer it from you until you rise up and say no more. You will not take another penny of my money. I don't care what you are doing with it, for you have demonstrated you cannot be trusted with it. If you promise me you're going to build new roads or protect me or feed the hungry or clothe the poor, I do not care, because I do not believe for one moment that this is where this money will go, for you have proven to me time and again that you will tell me that my money is going for these causes, but you will take it and instead invest it in your war machine, in your propaganda machine, in your control machines, and I will not stand for this one more moment in time, and I am now going to take back what power you have stolen from me, and I am going to take back every single penny you have stolen from me and my family, and that is exactly what is going on in your world today. You have brothers and sisters who are fighting for your freedom. They are fighting for your health and your welfare, and they are battling to take back everything that has been taken from you, including your monies. This is what is going on behind the scenes every moment of every day, whether you see this or not. Whether you believe this or not, we are telling you today, and you could remember this sentence, there is a war going on, there are battles breaking out all over your planet. Simply because it is not reported on the news does not mean it is not happening. As a matter of fact, if it is reported on your news, you may be pretty sure it is not really happening, and that is the way we see it from our perspective. Everything that you are shown, everything that you are told on your television sets is a lie, is a work of fiction. We ask you, why do you even turn them on in the morning? This leaves us scratching our heads, as it is the number one tool used against you, to control you, to sicken you, to make you think things that you don't want to think, to make you believe things that you would never believe in 1,000 years, yet so many of you believe these things because you have seen somebody, a paid actor, say this on television. They read from a teleprompter. The scripts are written from their high offices, just as our messages to you are written from our high offices and shared to you through our channels. Their scripts are written by agents of the cabal. Why do you listen to their garbage? We cannot answer this, only you can, but we can urge you to turn off your televisions and take away from them one of their greatest and most powerful and most effective weapons of destruction, of propaganda, of mind control, influence and persuasion. Thank you so much, dear ones, for allowing us to share our thoughts with you today. We love you all so very much, and this is why sometimes it may seem as if we are chastising you, although we are not. Sometimes we must act as your older brother or older sister. You can understand this, can't you? From our perspective, we see so much more than you because we remember all of our past incarnations and all of the lessons that we have learned consciously, so in a way we have certainly experienced more than you, although when you do return to full consciousness this will change, of course, and you will know as more and even more than we know and have learned and experienced. But right now this is not the case. The fact remains that we see more than you do. We utilize that advantage and we wish to share that advantage with you, and this is why sometimes we speak to you as if you are our kid brother or sister. It is because we love you and we care about you and we wish no more than you wish to see you and your world continue on in this manner. We wish to change everything right now, at this very moment, but we cannot. for we are not getting enough assistance from you, the people of Earth. There are those of you with jobs to do, and all we can do day in and day out is urge you to do them. We cannot force you to do them. We can explain to you why these tasks are so important to be carried out. We can assure you that you will be rewarded through your efforts. We can assure you how your planet, your world and your communities will change once these tasks are completed, and we can paint for you a picture of what will happen if these tasks are not completed, and this is not a pretty picture, and we do not like to talk about this often, and as you have noticed, we do not. We refrain as much as we can from painting you any dark scenarios that may arise through your lack of effort or your failure to achieve certain goals. We do this because we do not wish to plant these dark seeds in your garden. There are those of you who think that we slip these negative connotations into our messages to trick you, to influence you, to mind control you, and we say to that this is a load of rubbish. What we do is very clear for all to see. We build you up, we help strengthen you, we give you confidence, we remind you of the powerful and eternal spiritual beings that you are, we encourage you to complete your tasks, we assure you that we are protecting you, we advise you on how we feel it would be most beneficial to all of you to proceed, and we organize and structure programs and projects that will see to the benefit of all of the people of your world and your planet as well, as she too is a living, breathing and conscious being. This is what we do, and for those of you who still insist that we are perpetrating a con, a hoax or a scam and we have notions of conquering your planet, we say the time for your rhetoric has now ended. You, the paid minions of the cabal, and even those of you who are simply making what we see as a very imprudent choice for yourselves, you are now going to be rooted out like ugly weeds in a garden, for this is all you are at this point. As the time for these games, for these shenanigans, for these ploys, for these tactics, for these underhanded measures has now reached its end. We will take certain matters into our own hands, this you can be sure of. We will not wait one moment longer for our Earth allies to do some of the tasks that we have now decided to do. This does not, and we repeat loudly and clearly for all of you who seem to read some of these messages as if you are half asleep, we say to you we will not carry out the arrests of the members of your criminal cabal. We have made ourselves clear on this point many times in your past, and we will always remind you of this, as this is one task that you must complete yourselves as has been decreed by your Creator, and there is no way we will overstep our bounds and go back on our word and the promise that we have made to your Creator, who is also our Creator. These arrests, we remind you again, must take place. If they do not, the projects and programs that we have spoken of will not take place, for we are not stepping one foot on your soil until we feel it is a safe place to work, for we did not come here to step into a battle zone. We have had many battles in our storied history, you can be assured of this, and we pick and choose our battles very well and very wisely. We do not just enter frays that are not our business, and what is happening here in your world is not our business. Believe it or not, although we are your family, we are just visitors, and whether you, the people of Earth, choose or not to free yourselves really is inconsequential to us. We will have broken hearts, we will be saddened for you, and we will lament how many wonderful opportunities you allowed to slip through your fingers. But we will not allow these emotions to drag us into a war that is not ours, it is yours. We have, as we have assured you, leveled the playing field somewhat. We have taken away the Cabal's most powerful weapons, as you may have read recently throughout your online communities. The story that reported that some of the most powerful worldwide weaponry possessed and used against you by the Cabal has now been unplugged, has now been dismantled and cannot and will not be used against you, the people of Earth, is accurate. These are the kinds of things we will do for you and we will continue to do for you, but we will not take this battle into our own hands. This is your war. The playing field is now very level. There is absolutely no reason why your highly trained troops and law enforcement officials cannot proceed and carry out and complete these warranted arrests of the criminal elements of your cabal. We say again, we are not asking the citizenry of your planet to pick up arms and go kicking indoors. We made that point very clear in a previous message and it was misunderstood, as again there are so many of you who are reading these messages with one eye closed or your mind completely on something else. You are jumping to conclusions and you are spreading rumor, innuendo and accusation. You are making our organization look bad, and we cannot be any clearer in these messages. We clearly advised the Earth allies, who all of you should know by now are your organized, highly trained and official military factions of your world, coupled with your official, highly trained and skilled law enforcement agencies of your world. This is who your Earth allies are. The people of Earth, the citizens of Earth, are not the Earth allies. The citizenry is not included in these discussions, for it is not the job of the citizen to bear their own weapons and it is not their right to make illegal and unconstitutional arrests of other citizens. This is not applicable under your laws of your nations, and we fully understand this and we would never advise any of your unlicensed and unofficial citizens to take any part in any of these arrests. For all of you that have helped spread this vicious rumor that we called to the citizens of your planet to take up arms and kick indoors and make unwarranted, illegal and unconstitutional arrests, we say shame on you, for some of you are simply not using your God-given minds while others have purposely spread this rumor, this disinformation, this poison, and as you, those who purposely spread these lies, these deceits and are sabotaging our mission who will now be dealt with in ways that only we can deal with you. We have powers of violence control as well. In other words, and let us be clear about this, our ways are not violent, your ways are violent, and we have ways to control your violence. Have we been clear about that, dear ones, that it is not violence that we employ, it is violence we stop, and we will now make every effort to stop the violence that some of you are committing throughout your online communities, and again, you are committing an act of violence and words are your weapon. So if any of you feel you have nothing to worry about because you haven't made a fist and struck another being, we say to you that you are in for a very rude awakening, for the acts of violence that you have committed with your tongue, and we have ways of dealing with you, and we will. This is all we have to share with you today, dear ones, and we say to you that for those of you who want a better world, for those of you who want all the things that have been discussed and all of the gifts that can and will be offered to you once your tasks here are completed, we say to you we will not desert you, we will not leave you, we will not leave your side, not for one moment. We, your brothers and sisters, are here with you and we will continue our fight. It is just that some areas of this fight are your domain and you must complete these assignments yourselves, that is all. We are certainly living up to our end of the bargain and we are even upping the ante, as we never had any intention of coming here and silencing those who have attacked us or abused us through the use of words, but a point has been reached and we now have convened and we now have reached a unanimous decision that these words that have been used against us are acts of terrorism. They have now breached the realms of free speech and expression and have now escalated into the realm of psychotronic warfare. This is a well-used tactic in this universe, and we are very experienced and well-suited to protect ourselves from this sort of terrorist act. We have very proven and effective methods to deal with these assaults and this is what we now will do, and for those of you who are on our side, who now stand on the side of law, of truth, of justice, of love and of light, you can take solace in knowing that we are now stepping up our game. You wanted to see some changes in your world and you wanted to see us make some of them. Well, you are now going to witness what it is we can do when we choose to do it and put our minds to achieving a goal. We are your fellow comrades in arms, your brothers and sisters, your fellow fighting forces on the front lines battling for good. We are the Galactic Federation of Light.